Hello everyone, thank you for joining my tutorial. I am Vikas Gadamode, research scholar in National Geophysical Research Institute, Hyderabad. In this tutorial, we are going to delineate watershed using digital elevation model. So, to start a delineate watershed, you need to download digital elevation model about your study area. For downloading a digital elevation model, you can download it from USGS Earth Explorer. In the USGS Earth Explorer, you can choose area where you want to download. Suppose this is my study area. So, after choosing this study area, I will go to data set. In data set, I will choose a digital elevation. In digital elevation, it shows that SRTM. So one arc SRTM, this one I will select. Then show result. I will go to result. And you can see this. We have to download this much of imagery coming in our study area. So this one, if your area is large, there will be more DEM you have to download. So for practice purpose, we are downloading one DEM here. So you have to click here, download option. So when you will click here, then they will ask for login. But here I'm already logged in here. So I will download the data. So now you can able to see it's downloading here. So after download, we'll open our ArcGIS, or we'll add our data. So this data we have downloaded. Now I'm adding it. Press OK. So you can able to see this image. Is georeference, it's showing degree decimal. So I will project it first. For projection, I will go to R toolbox. In R toolbox, there is an option data management tool. In data management tool, we have to go projection and transformation. In projection and transformation, raster option is there. In raster, project raster option is there. So I will drag this image here. I will give some output folder. Suppose I'm creating new folder here. Output coordinate system. So here longitude shows mostly 76, 78 degrees Celsius. So we'll go to project coordinate system, UTM zone, WGS 1984, northern hemisphere. I will choose as a 43 UTM zone because 76 degrees fall under UTM 43 zone. okay, and I will press again okay. Now you can able to see project raster is here. So we'll start our all work in this projected raster. After projection, we start removing sinks or imperfection of a raster image. For that, we use fill tool. Whatever the sinks is there or imperfection is there, so that we are going to remove. For that, we'll go our spatial analysis tool. In spatial analysis tool, we have to go hydrology and then fill. Input surface raster, I will choose as a tame. Output raster, we have to give. I will name it as a fill. Then okay. So here our fill raster is ready. Now we'll go for flow direction. To delineate the direction in which water will flow out of each cell, we'll calculate by using flow direction tool. So flow direction in spatial analysis tool, hydrology, flow direction tool is there. So input flow direction raster. So this is the raster of a hydrology flow direction. Now we are going to use basin tool to create a raster delineating all drainage basin. For that, we'll go spatial analysis tool, hydrology and basin. So asking input flow direction. So this flow direction, output raster I will give where I have to save my file. So I will give name it as a basin. Save. Okay. Our basin is getting ready. So these are all the basins which are coming in our area. Now we'll convert this basin into polygon. Now it's in raster, so we'll convert it to, we'll transform it into the polygon. So for that, we'll go conversion tool. In conversion tool, there is a from raster to polygon. Basin, press OK. So this is our basin, this one is basin. There are number of basins we can see. Now we select one hour basin polygon and we clip it shape file of all basin polygon using clip tool. So under geoprocessing, there is a clip tool. So this we will extract. For that, this is our raster basin. So from raster basin 1, where this selected file we are taking out. Now you can see our basin is ready. After that, we may create the stream net. For that, so we will call it as, so we will, for that we'll do our flow direction, flow accumulation map first. So making a flow accumulation map, I will go again spatial analysis tool, hydrology. In hydrology, there is a flow accumulation. We are using this tool to calculate the number of upslope cells flowing to the location. For that, here it says that input flow direction raster. So input flow direction raster I will select, then output I will give it as a flow accumulation. To create a flow accumulation, it will take little longer time. So this is our flow accumulation. Now we'll go to map algebra and raster calculator. This we are doing to create a stream network. For that, we'll give it name as a, we'll give some condition to create a stream network map. So condition I will choose as a flow accumulation, it's greater than or equal to 500 1 comma 0. This condition we are giving to remove hanging stream which is present into the map. So larger the basin, you can select as a larger number, whatever you want to select, you can select. If your basin is large, you can select as 1000. If basin is small, you can select as 100. It should not remain any hanging stream. So for that I am giving 250 here. Again I will choose a folder where I have to save it. So I will give name as a stream network. Now you can see our stream network is created. Then after converting stream network, we are going to convert it into the stream order. So you can able to see it's only a raster file, and where we don't know which is first order, which is second order. So for that we'll decide the order, stream order. Just we have created stream network that I am selecting. Then input flow direction. So flow direction our map that I am adding here. Then output. Stream order. Save. Here is asking a method. So by default, I will keep as a trailer method. Okay. Now you can see our order is now decided, which is first order, which is second order. Now it's in raster format. We'll convert it into a vector format. For converting, there is a stream to feature option is there. Stream order map we have created. Then input flow direction map. This is our flow direction map. And output raster I will give. Stream to feature. For ordering this, we'll go to properties, symbology, categories, select grid code, apply, OK. So you can see first order, second order image. This is our selected basin. So we'll remove this, or we'll extract this by R toolbox. In R toolbox, we'll clip it. For clipping, we'll go analysis tool, extraction, or clip. Input feature, our stream to feature on chat that we just have created. Clip raster, this one is our selected basin. Output raster, our final watershed map. So now you can also clip this feature also. Now you can able to see this map is ready. So finally, this is watershed delineation using great hydrological model modeling tool. So under ArcGIS and spatial analysis tool we have used it mostly. Thanks for watching this interesting tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you for your patience. See you in the next video.